Hi guys, Matthew Woodward here, and today I'm going to show you the free If This Then That service and why it is absolutely amazing. I'll take you through it all, including how to set it up and use it so you can get more done in less time. I'll also let you get a sneak peek of how I use it behind the scenes to manage a blog and create content. And I'm even going to step outside of the box and show you some other juicy If This Then That hints and tips. So are you ready? Then let's go. If This Then That is a really simple but powerful service that allows you to connect all sorts of different channels. So to give you a real example of how it works, I'm going to show you some of their more popular recipes. For example, when a Facebook profile picture changes, update the Twitter profile picture. Every time you tagged in a photo on Facebook, save it to Dropbox. And we can have a look at some more. Every time you star something in Google Reader, create a note in Evernote. Every time an RSS update happens, tweet about it. And you can see there's lots of different recipes here that people have already created, and you can combine any of the services to make your own. Now, If This Then That is actually compatible with a huge range of services here. You've got everything from Facebook, Evernote, Gmail, RSS feeds, readability. All you have to do is create an account and then you can start creating your own recipes. So to create an account, just come up to join here and fill out the details, and I'm going to log in and pause the video. So this is the main dashboard when you log in, and you can see here I've got 24 recipes for various tasks, and I'm going to show you those a little bit later on. But first of all, let's take a look at creating our own recipe. So if we click create a recipe, we can say if this happens and then pick from any one of these services. So let's go with something simple. Let's say that every week you've got a certain task that you like to perform. So you can say every weekday, so every Monday at 9 a.m. I want you to create a note in Evernote. And I might say title, reply to social media messages. And then in the body, I can say Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Google Plus. Now I use the secret weapon as my getting things done organization, so this will probably make a bit more sense to you, but that notebook is going to action pending with the tags one now, Matthew Woodward, which is a project at work, and then create action, add a description, social media reminder, create recipe. So now every Monday at 9 a.m. a new note will appear in Evernote reminding me to reply to all of my social media messages. And you know, creating recipes are really easy. It's always this interface, first pick your first service and the various triggers that that offers, you know, RSS feed, and then you pick your second one. So that's how you create your own recipes. It's really, really simple. But let's take a look at some of the recipes that I use and how I use them to automate tasks on my blog and help with content creation. So first of all, let's take a look at how I use a service to create the income report roundup posts every month. This is just a list of blogs and how much they earn with a few notes about how they did it. And if you look at If This Then That, you can see I've got all of these recipes set up that basically, once they publish their income report, it instantly gets added to Evernote. So let's have a look at this in a bit more detail. So this says, if the new RSS feed item matches income report, then append to a note in Evernote. And you can see here, the trigger is if the new feed item matches the income report from that feed, append to the note truevalhalla.com along with some information there. So let's take a look at what that actually looks like in Evernote. And you can see here already there's been 5 income reports published. So when I come to writing the post, I don't need to go and find the post. I've just got all the information here. Here are all the earnings numbers and how they did it. And it just makes it really quick and easy to put the income report roundup post together. So that's one way that I use it. Another one of the posts I publish is the What Have I Read This Month post, which is just a collection of all of my favourite posts throughout the month. And the way I go about this is, first of all, I have lots of RSS subscriptions set up in Google Reader for various sites. And then I use If This Then That to create this recipe. So every item I star in Google Reader gets added to Evernote. And down here, you can see that it just pulls in the URL, the content, and adds it to the reading list notebook. So if we jump to Evernote, you can see a list of articles here that are in my reading list. And I also use the Firefox plugin. So when there is something that I want to add that I'm just browsing, I just come up here, click the Evernote button, and that will go straight into my reading list there. So that's how I use it to create those posts. I also use it to help me keep on top of my editorial calendar, which you can see here. This is just a Google calendar imported into my email client, mapping out the posts that I want to create that month. So if we look at If This Then That, you can see that I have created this recipe here that says if any event starts on editorial, then create a note in Evernote. And that just creates it in the Action Pending notebook at work with the Matthew Woodward project tag and now. So I know that it needs to be done now. And as you can see in Evernote here, here is a note telling me to publish the post and when to do it, along with a link to any notes that I added when I created the calendar event. So that's how I use it to help manage the blog and the editorial calendar. So I'm hoping you start to see how useful this really is. The limit really is your own imagination with this. I mean, let's take a look at creating a recipe for backing up our blog posts. We could just say, if this, if an RSS feed is updated, here's a feed URL, then create a new note in Evernote with all of the information and add it to the blog backup notebook. Create the action, call it blog backup, and every time the blog is updated, it copies the post straight into Evernote, so you've got an instant backup of it. And you know, you can do the same here for your tweets. You can use it, you could back that straight up into Dropbox and it'll create a text file in Dropbox with the information instead. You could also use it to do things like, let's take a look, what have we got? Stock prices. If a certain stock price rises above, let's say 1,000, then you may want it to send you a text message, for example, or to send you an instant message on Google Talk to alert you of the stock price. There's no limit really with this tool whatsoever, you know. And we've only got to, if we come back here and browse some of the other recipes that people have created, you can see that the diverse range of functions that this has. I mean, look, here, save your tweets to a Google Drive spreadsheet. That's really handy for backing things up. Star a Google Reader article and send it to read later. There really is just endless possibilities of what you can do with this. So that is If This Then That, which is a completely free service that is easy to use and really powerful. I recommend you get creative with your own recipes, from getting weather updates all the way through to automating your home with the Wemo channels.